Okay, next up, we're going to look at some very basic colour theory. You could probably write an entire encyclopedia on colour theory, but when it comes to the basis of design, there's really only one thing that you need to understand, and that is complementary colours. Now, we've got a basic colour wheel in front of us. Now, all tones and shades of colour are mixed from our three primaries, which, of course, are yellow, blue, and red. Now, if you're an artist mixing oil paints, for example, every other colour that you can imagine starts with those three primaries. So that's kind of the basics of colour mixing. But when it comes to design for print, I think complementary colours are a great idea. And to deduce a complementary colour, you basically look at a colour wheel and then you draw a line across to the other side of the wheel and you can find that colour's exact opposite. And that can offer all kinds of benefits in the world of print. Now, I'm not saying go out there and create your corporate identity based on complementary colours. To be honest, they can be quite stark to the eye. But if you want to create something that really stands out, you would have, for example, maybe a green background with red type. And that's a really jarring set of colours. And if you don't have a colour wheel and you don't want to use one, don't worry too much about it, because PaintShop Pro offers an exceptional tool which pretty much does it for you. So just click on any colour switch, give it a double click. And when the colour wheel opens up, the initial wheel, now let's just pick a colour. Complementary colours aren't offered if you're in grayscale or black and white, but you'll see that now I've picked this kind of muddy yellow that we've got a few icons that have appeared across the top. And the complementary icon is the second colour in. And what that will do is quantify, based on your selected colour, where its exact opposite is within the wheel. So you don't need to reference charts or Pantone numbers or anything crazy like that. So if I just randomly pick a colour, it'll show me in the opposite end of the scale by clicking in the little circle what its exact opposite is. And the same goes if you want to work in triads or analogic colours or accented colours or anything like that. This is a really handy tool, and it means that you can dip into colour theory without having to do much reading, which is extremely useful. So like I said at the beginning, there's an awful lot to learn about colour theory, but this should hopefully be enough to remind you at the very least that there are considerations that you can make before going into the production phase.